Backstage Live.
We're now in our new headquarters for the Backstage Live.
Yes, which is nice and roomy, nice and little cozy, which will be our permanent headquarters now for the Backstage Live. So from now on, this is what you will see. Us in this little table and cup and mug and yeah. So yes, welcome back to the Backstage Live. We are now in episode 9. We're approaching episode 10, which will be in a couple of weeks' time. Oh yeah, episode 10, let's go. But yes, anyway. So today's episode is specially dedicated to a particular show that's coming out called The Wizard of Oz. Now, I'm sure many of you know what The Wizard of Oz is about. If not, you've had a very sad childhood. I'm just being honest. I mean, every person knows what Wizard of Oz is. And so yeah, Pan Productions, who recently did Cabaret and Always in Wonderland, they are bringing Wizard of Oz down to KL Pack. And we, our special correspondent, our guest host, Shahila Johan, was at the press conference of Wizard of Oz. So why don't you take a look at what she managed to find?
Hi everybody, it's Shahila Johan. I am here today at Rajaya Hotel for the press conference of Wizard of Oz, brought to you by Rajaya Hotel and Kenny Rogers.
Thomas. Flushed so covered by flies, plentiful earth mother, she lights up your eyes. Can the song recall what the heart does not feel? All of nights in Havana finally disappear. Thomas, Thomas, she flushed so.
Hello, so we have Peter Ong playing the scarecrow.
Hello, fam.
So, how is it wearing the straw?
Young me? It's prickly, it's bloody prickly.
Yeah,
I use L'Oreal because I'm worth it. Maybe I should take that back.
But okay, so what's your preparation for being a scarecrow? Like?
Preparation. One of the hardest things I think is the body language, because the scarecrow is floppy, so I need to figure out how the scarecrow stands, sits, walks, runs, falls, which I do all the time, so I can bruise on my hip, bruise on my knee, elbow, you know. Yeah, you know, but yeah, that's the role, lah. But it's,
you're having fun, right?
It's a fun role, yeah.
Challenging, but fun role.
Yeah, it's very physically challenging.
It's been hectic with Miss Ng. It's been good because, you know, it's like we have to be 10 steps ahead, and it's quite like in a week time, during a week duration, we had to like, day of work ready, come on, like, you know, you understand what I'm talking about?
Yes, definitely.
So you gotta do your homework at 12 minutes after you come back from rehearsals, and sleep at 3, and then tomorrow go back at 1, 2, that kind of thing.
Well, same thing all over again, but it's been fun.
It's been awesome, my cast is fabulous, they work very hard, and I'm having lots of fun. Some sleepless nights, but it's just normal.
So, how does it feel to be an evil villain?
It feels horrible! I'm ugly all the time!
But the director is here, so I cannot say much.
Yeah, that's the finger. Okay, so how's the personal process going?
It's been intense. We've been jumping scenes actually, so I'm a bit like confused. It's fun because we get to act with this cutest little dog ever. Well, of course I have to hate him because I want to eat him.
You're great, and I love working with this cute girl called Stephanie Bendis. I missed working with her once. I've seen her on stage. She's a newbie actually, but she's so pro, man. This is Stephanie Bendis.
And she's playing Dorothy.
She's Korean plus Italian. And the name.
He's wrong.
Knock on my chest with me, come perfect.
Hello.
Why do you want everyone to watch Wizard of Oz?
Because it's effing fun.
The weird winkies, well, they dance very well.
The weird winkies, huh?
Ah, the winkies. We got flying monkeys, you know. I don't know how they're gonna make them fly, but they're gonna fly. I think so. Or maybe I'll make them fly. If they don't fly, I'll fly them.
Because he's really adorable.
I know.
Because it's fun, it's magical, and it leaves you a very nice feeling. Go home and smile. Smile from within. Come to the Wizard of Oz.
So yes, that was The Wizard of Oz.
Be sure to catch it. Don't miss it because there are only six shows left.
Yes, there are only six shows left. So if you look across your screen right now, those are the shows that's left. So make sure you get your tickets in advance because it's probably going to sell out really quick. So yeah, so while you're thinking about which shows to go to, why don't you also check out what's happening in the next 2 weeks. Come to a close for another episode of The Backstage Life. We hope you had fun watching The Wizard of Oz and the little munchkins and the Scarecrow and all the rest of the characters.
Yeah.
So make sure you catch that out, and we will see you again in a couple of weeks' time.
So, Nick, who are you playing in The Wizard of Oz?
Come and watch and find out. Until then, I'm Nick Dorian.
And I'm Sharon Lam.
And this has been The Backstage Life.